labels, where they existed, came about because of a phenomena. And really the first were the baby boomers, and that's because they were part of this post-World War II baby boom. But after the baby boomers, we had an emerging generation in the early 90s without a label. And Douglas Copeland, Canadian writer, actually said, look, call us X. You know, we're not like the boomers. We defy a label. And that became the label, Generation X. And then we had Generation Y and Generation Z just naturally flowing from that. But as we've arrived at the end of the alphabet, and as that was approaching, actually, in the early 2000s, we had a look. I was writing a book on the generations and thought, well, you know, we don't want to go back to A, even though we surveyed people and said, what do you think the generation after Z should be called? And A was a common one, or the dot-com kids, or the iGen, the screen ages, all these sorts of labels emerge. But again, that's part of the problem. Labeling a generation based on what is current at the moment. We need something that can create meaning over time, that's more of a blank label, more of a scientific approach. So that's when I put forward the Greek naming approach, Generation Alpha, because this is the first generation born from 2010 on, so fully born in the 21st century, in this new era of technology, a global generation with rising life expectancy, big numbers of births as well. And that label is stuck, and that then leads us to the next letter, Generation Beta, and then Generation Gamma, and Generation Delta, and Generation Epsilon as well. And if that approach sticks, I think it's helpful because it firstly allows people to understand the sequential nature of it. They can work out what the next generation is based on what the next letter is. When we were in the pandemic, you know, each new strain of virus was given, you know, Omicron or Epsilon or whatever. And that's what is used in science often in nomenclature, is Greek alphabet labeling. And it allows it to create its own meaning rather than have a meaning put upon it from the outside. And it also reminds us of the scientific nature of the behavioral science of generations. And if we have set spans of birth time, 15 years, and more scientific labeling, alpha, beta, gamma, delta, then it allows more of a sociological approach to generational analysis, comparisons, insights. It moves from the pop culture frame to something that helps us understand populations in the future. So